Hey YouTubers, it's Alex. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be doing another Instagram 101 video, and it's going to be based off one of the comments that were left on my first Instagram 101 video, which is what apps I use to create my Instagram posts, which is a great question. I do use a couple different apps. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to talk about different types of pictures that I post, because what apps I use is based off of the whole process is different for each type, like a selfie versus a product shot versus a boomerang post. So I'm gonna go over the different types with you guys. And before we get started, I just wanna give you an overall summary of the apps that I use. And the main ones that I use are Facetune, InstaSize, and RookieCam. And sometimes I use PicStitch and ClipStitch. Now I do several different types of posts on Instagram. And the first one I'm gonna go over with you is selfies. So whenever I take selfies, I use my Sony A5100 camera. It is the best camera for selfies, at least that I have tried. Way better than the Canon one that I have right here. And also it's lighter. And then also better than the iPhone. Sometimes I get lucky with the iPhone, but this one is what I trust most. And when I do take photos though, I take a million selfies. So what I do is I take my selfies on here, I import them into iPhoto on my Mac laptop, and then I go through and pick out my favorite, and then I do edit out some like wrinkles on, I'm gonna be real with you. I add out some wrinkles or pimples or something that pop up on my skin on the iPhoto app that's on my laptop. So that's what I start off with. If I'm doing selfies and I notice like I have something in my teeth, I can use one of the retouch buttons and get whatever's out of my teeth and just kind of touch up there. So I do touch up some of my skin whenever I'm in there. And then what I do is I go onto my iMessage on my laptop, send the photo to myself, and then I open up the photo on my iMessage on here. So I'm gonna show you, do a video on that, but I send stuff to myself all of the time on a daily basis through iMessage on my laptop and on my phone. So then what I do is I download the photo that I sent on my messages and then put it into my photos on my phone. Once I have it on my phone, I go into Facetune. So, like I said, I'm working on a selfie right now. I want my skin to look good, so I do use Facetune. I use the Smoother app, and I smooth out my skin. For whatever reason, my skin just looks super bumpy. I don't feel like it looks like it in person, but this camera is so good that it really picks up on your imperfections. Now, the quality of your makeup is great. Like, everything is so perfect, but then sometimes if you have any skin imperfections, you can really see it. I think you can put, like, on a softening thing on your camera, like a little filter, but like I don't know how to do that and I don't feel like figuring it out. Like I'm like constantly like go, so it's hard for me to stop and read instructions. I just kind of like figure things out as I go. But yeah, so what I do is I go into Facetune and then I just touch up around my skin. So any piece of skin that I show, I cover up. I use the smoothing app to smooth it out. Then if I'm smiling or I'm showing any teeth, I use the whitener to whiten my teeth, because if you guys saw my Carbon Cocoa video, my teeth, that's on my Beauty Addict Next Door YouTube channel, I did a close-up shot of my teeth before I brushed my teeth, and it was after I ate though, to be fair, but they're disgusting. Like, they're not super bad, but they're like, not the way that I want to show the world. So if I have any teeth showing, then I go in with that app, unless for some reason I go in with the whitener and my teeth end up looking weird, because sometimes the way the light hits your teeth, if you go in with the whitening app, it picks up weird. So sometimes I don't. So if it ends up looking weird, I just don't do it. But if it looks fine, then I use a whitener on my teeth. And then I just save. I save both copies. I save the first copy of just the skin softening. And then I save another copy after I've done the teeth. And then once I have the one that I'm like finally ready to post, then I message that back to myself onto my laptop for whenever I work on my thumbnail for YouTube. But that's a separate thing. So it's saved now. The new photo with the skin softened through Facetune, the teeth whitened through Facetune. Now I want to upload it to InstaSize so that it's ready to go for Instagram. So I upload it into InstaSize, and then all I do is I expand the photo so that way the whole photo fits in that square box and there's no like white showing. So I just make sure that it fits in the box. And then I just export it out of InstaSize and put it right back onto my camera roll. So now that it's on camera roll, I go into my next app called RookieCam. I upload it there, and the only thing that I'm doing in here is just adding on a tag. So I'm just putting in text that I'm doing at Beauty Addict Next Door, at alex.n.welch, depending on which account that I am putting the Instagram photo on. So I, and then what I do, here, let me pull up a photo. I just did one. So I go to the star, I go to the text, I type in the text, then I go to pretty much fade the text, and then I put it somewhere in the photo so that way you can see my tag, but it's also not too harsh and in your face. I try to hide it enough that it doesn't like ruin the photo, but enough that you can see it and understand what the text says, that people know that this is my photo. So once I have that tag done and it's in place, then I just export it out of RookieCam, and then I'm ready to upload to Instagram. Once I upload it to Instagram, I don't do any editing on Instagram. It's all ready to go, and I don't like the idea of editing on Instagram because I'm worried it's not going to save properly, or you go through all the, I don't know. I just feel like it's safer to get it all done before you go to Instagram. Because let's say you go through all these things, and then you go to post it and it doesn't post, or something goes wrong with your camera and then you did all that editing and it just went away, or I don't know. So I think it's just better to do it all ahead of time. So then I just, you know, upload the photo onto Instagram and then I post it once I've done the description box and everything. So that's how I do a selfie. Now, if I am doing a product shot, like for instance, a makeup of the day post where I'm showing you a picture of all the makeup that I wore that day, or if I'm doing a close-up of one product, I use one of two cameras, and I use either this Canon T5i that I'm filming on right now. I also use my iPhone. And sometimes what I do is I take pictures with both and then pick what I like the best, because for some reason, depending on the lighting or what mood my camera seemed to be in, sometimes the Canon works better and sometimes the iPhone works better. So I kind of like flip-flop between using them and just seeing what works best, and that's what I do. I prefer it when the iPhone works better, because on the iPhone you can use the square, so you can take pictures in the square, so it's already Instagram size. With my Canon, I just have to make sure that I'm far enough away, so that way when I go to expand it, it all fits in with that 6x12 square, so it's ready for Instagram. So I prefer it to work on my phone, especially if like I'm on the go and stuff, but sometimes the iPhone doesn't work, and I have an iPhone 6S. I definitely do want to upgrade down the road, but I'm just not ready to do that at this point, because I do want a better camera. But this Canon T5i will work if this one doesn't. One of the two will work. I don't think I've ever experienced where one didn't work versus the other. I think it kind of just depends on the mood, the lighting, and you know which one feels like working better. It's probably the biggest thing is the lighting. Which one is better with what lighting is going on in the situation. So I use one of these two cameras to take product shots. Once I take the product shot, you know, if I'm doing it on the Canon T5i, I upload it to my iPhoto, pick my favorite, and then I send it to myself through iMessage from my laptop to my phone, then save it on my phone. If it's already on my phone, then it's already ready to go. So if I took the photo with my Canon T5i, I have to put that photo into InstaSize and make sure it fits in the 6x12 by 6x12 dimensions. So I expand the photo to make sure there's no white or whatever part of the shot I don't want shown, and then I just save it onto my camera roll, and then I go into RookieCam and put on the tag. Now, if I took the photo with my, you know, iPhone in the square setting, it's already at the size that it needs to be, so I don't even need to go into InstaSize. Then I just go into RookieCam and add the tag. Again, for the tags, I make sure I put in the text that's readable, but I also fade it so it's not so in your face. And then I just upload them to Instagram. Now, the third thing that I want to talk about with you guys is boomerang. So if you want a boomerang photo, if you're not sure what that is, I will insert that above here. But a boomerang pretty much is when you are showing a video shot of something where things just go back and forth. So people picking up their coffee, it's just going to go like, you know, it flips around. So those are kind of fun just to kind of switch up your Instagram so it's not just like flat photos. You can also do something that has more movement. Now, when I go to take those photos, I make sure that the beginning of me pressing down on the boomerang, the photo is still, so that way I can use that as my cover photo, because you don't want it to be moving so much that when you go to pick the cover photo, it's not clear. So I kind of hold it for a second, then I flip it. So that way I make sure I have a cover photo. So you just have to use the boomerang app, and I also make sure that, you know, when I'm doing it, I'm far enough away, so that way I go to fit it into InstaSize, it's good, because when boomerang, you can't, at least the last time that I went in there, you can't use InstaSize when you're doing the boomerang. You just have to do the full length photo. So if you're trying to do a product shot with boomerang, you have to make sure that you're far back from it so that there's more background. So that way when you go to crop it, it's just cropping out the background and not the product shot. So once I got that video taken care of, I check it out. Sometimes what I have to do is export it out of boomerang onto my camera roll, upload it to InstaSize, and just keep testing out to see what fits. And then if it fits, it looks nice, then I just then I just save it to my camera roll. Hopefully this is, I feel like I'm talking a lot and going back and forth between like different apps and things that you need to do. So hopefully you guys are following me. But yeah, so I download it to my camera roll from InstaSize, and then I can't tag it because it's considered a video. It's like between a picture and a video, but it's I think it's more of a video than a picture, so you can't put a tag on it. So that's the only thing that sucks about that. But then again, people are gonna have a hard time screenshotting it than they would if it was just a photo. Like, they would have to hit the right moment to get it at the right, clarity with the photo. So then I just upload it to Instagram, and then I post it. Then the last thing is video. So if you want to upload a video, what can you do? And actually, there's a lot of different things. So I'm doing, like, the four basics. I guess the next things would be collages. So maybe I can do a separate video on how to do like collages or multiple pictures. So if you guys want to see me talk about doing collages on Instagram, doing multiple photos on Instagram, I can go into the more depth into those. I'm just going to cover the basics, and then once I get into that, I'll do that. But so I'll save that. So that's kind of where Pick Stitch and Clip Stitch come in. So I think I'll do a separate video for that because this is already getting long, but I want to kind of go over the basics and then I can get more into the detail of the more complex stuff. So if I'm doing a video, I have to make sure that the video fits in the InstaSize. So you can upload that video to InstaSize, and then you can edit from there and expand it and make sure it fits in, and then you just save it to your camera roll. Once again, you can't use Rookie Cam to add the tag. So, and then if I want to do, not that I've done it, I think I may have done one, or I've attempted to do two and I've yet to post them, but I have done other videos where I've done like lip swatch, like I did my Elle Lego lipstick lip swatch video. So I wanted to include that on Instagram, so I had to make sure that, you know, I was far enough back to include the clip, so that way whenever I expanded it in InstaSize, it fit and I didn't get cut off. So you kind of have to be careful. Like, so if you're doing an Instagram makeup tutorial, you can't film super close up and then expand it in your Insta story, your InstaSize, because once you expand it, you're going to cut off part of what you're doing. So if you're going to film an Instagram makeup tutorial, make sure it's like this, at least this far away. So that way because see, this is a 1280 by 720, you're going to be cutting it down to like this and like here. So you want to make sure that it fits. So you also got to keep that in mind whenever you're doing videos. How's it going to fit? Unless you want to do the 1280 by 720 and then do like some sort of random background, but I don't think that looks as nice. I think it's better to get whatever photo, video, boomerang post to fit in the 612 by 612 sizing. I think whenever you have to do like fill in the background with other random stuff or a blurry picture in the background, I don't think it looks as nice. It works if you really need it to work, but and also it seems like on Instagram they've updated it so you can post like 1280 by 720 posts. And then, like, if you look on your feed, it looks like it's in a square. It's going to be closer up, though. But if you're scrolling through your feed, you see it in the 1280 by 720 form. Am I wrong? Like, I've been, like, going through Instagram super quickly. Like, so I'm not 100% sure. But let me know if, like, Instagram, like, allows you to do that and it still looks nicer. Like, I think they've made it so it looks nicer now. But I would still try to make everything fit in the 612 by 612. So, but like I said, if you have a video, just pull it onto your camera roll, upload it to InstaSize, size it right, and then you can just upload it onto Instagram and post it. All right, that's it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know down in the comments if you want me to do a part two of this to go into the more in-depth types of things like collages and multiple pictures on Instagram. I'd be happy to do that for you guys. Now, if you haven't subscribed to my channel already, please make sure to hit the subscribe button below. Click that little bell so that you're notified of when my videos have been posted. Like this video if you did like it, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye! And in this series, I'm going to be going over with you guys my top 10 most popular videos on each of my channel. So every year, I'm going to do these videos, and it's going to be one time per channel each year. So I have 5 channels, so I'm going to go over with you guys 5 times in 2017 my top 10 most popular videos across all of my channels, and then I'll just keep doing them the following years, just doing updated versions. You guys.